Hello, everyone, and welcome to CNC of Course. This is the section dedicated to Heidenhain programming. The very first things we're going to look at won't immediately be about practice, but will serve to create a common area of knowledge of the machine so that we can take it for granted when we have to deal with the things that are a little more complex. We'll start to see the programming languages and the structure of the numerical control. Above all, we will be using the latest model, the TNC640, although there will also be references to the previous 530. I'm Gabriella, and Paolo, the picky programmer, is also here. Now, let's get this started and introduce you to Heidenhain on CNC, of course. Heidenhain provides three different languages: the klartext programming, the ISO language, and the smart TNC, but this can only be edited on 530 models. Heidenhain's klartext programming is conversational, meaning I give an instruction to the control and then answer the questions that are asked. The dialogue with control is initiated with this set of keys, through which you can enter the tool data, create and execute subprograms, or define and launch fixed cycles. With this other set of keys, you can manage movements and the creation of geometric contours. The conversational system revolves around three main buttons: Enter, with which to confirm the entry and move on to the next question; No Enter, to go directly to the next question and then skip the dialogue; End, to abort the dialogue. This will be the language we will be dealing with during this cycle of lessons. Another possibility is to use the ISO language, which is a language common to many non-Heidenhain machines, consisting of letters, numbers, and codes. There are no questions or help, but it requires the operator to know the correct syntax. But beware, ISO was born as a universal language, but over time, each builder has added its own commands. So an ISO program edited on another machine cannot be loaded on your Heidenhain control or vice versa and expect it to be executed. But you will have the possibility of continuing with programming that you may have already known because you have already used it previously. Compared to the klartext programming, you have far fewer functions available. Or on a 530 control, you can also use smart TNC, which is again conversational but further simplified. It can also be used in combination with klartext programming and basically allows you to group program parts into actual work steps called units. Let's continue by looking at the structure of your control. The beating heart of everything is contained in the TNC, and you can organize your work either by creating directories or simple files. Files can be part programs, tables, or even drawings. With this structure, you can divide the different parts of your work into several files and keep them in the same directory, which can have the name of the customer or the job number. Let's start by saying that each file has a name and an extension. A program written using klartext programming will have the extension H, an ISO program I, a smart TNC program HU. You can also create or import other types of files, such as tables, a work offset table, D, palettes, P, or a point table, also known as a pattern, PNT. In this course, we will focus on H programs. So with the klartext program, then in the next lesson, we will see how to create and manage tables. Pressing the editing key followed by program management splits the screen into two parts. The directories are on the left side and the files are on the right side. Simply move to one side or the other using the arrow keys on the keyboard and the soft keys at the bottom of the screen to operate on the directories or on the files. Are you getting bored, Paolo? Yes, you're right. Now, let's see how to start a new program. So we start our simulator, go to editing, then PGM-MGT, which is program management. And with the arrows on the keyboard, we position ourselves on the left, so in the area where we have the directories. Go to TNC, select the soft key new directory that we will call CNC, of course. At this point, we confirm with Enter, and we have created our folder inside the TNC. Now move to the right with the arrows and enter the name of your program followed by H. For example, exercise 1H, and confirm with Enter. We have created our program. The first question the control will ask is what measurement unit we want to work with. We will answer millimeters. At this point, our program has been started and the control already suggests us through the soft keys to define our blank. We will stop here for now, As you can see, the first and last lines of our program have been created. All the instructions and comments will go inside these two blocks, and the lines will be numbered automatically in a progressive, ascending way and with a step of one. In the same way, if a program is written or modified from a PC, you can ignore the numbering, because it will be renumbered automatically when you load it into your NC. Remember that empty lines are not allowed, and if you need to create a space between blocks to make them easier to read, you can enter a comment with a semicolon and leave it empty. Around and within this structure, you have one of the most comprehensive programming languages available. You can quickly and intuitively select your tools, manage datums and tables, apply scales and rotations. Of course, Paolo, you can also use subprograms, program section repeats, forms. Paolo, you are really demanding. Then I'll tell you that you can also open drawings and directly select the contours you need to machine. You have excellent 3D graphics so that you can test your programs before they are executed. And you can all make use of many cycles and functions that will allow you to challenge a CAM. Are you happy, Paolo? Very good. So, we will begin to see this and more from the next lesson. Paolo, try to be patient. You will become a master at this.